Hi, my little eager bees. Namaste. Hello, hello, hello.
We're getting set up here as well. But welcome for those of you that are on. You can let her know we're on just in case. So good morning. Another wonderful day of Don't Harsh My Mellow, day 9 of our Don't Harsh My Mellow free yoga, 8 a.m. for our conscious collective and healing for our world. Today we'll be focusing on hope during difficult circumstances. So just taking a few minutes to ground and settle. Caroline agrees. Focusing on hope in challenging circumstances. Oh, my girl. Yeah. So today we're going to be focusing on chair yoga. And I'm on the ground right now, but today's main focus is chair yoga. So if you have a chair or your couch or wherever you'd like to go today, you're welcome to and sit there. And if you want to have a pillow nearby, one of your pillow cushions nearby, absolutely utilize that as well. For those of you that are going to practice on the mat, you're welcome to do everything that we do on the mat. Make this your personal journey and your personal practice as we collectively flow together, as long as we're in same unison. To begin, in your chair, please lengthen through your spine, root your feet onto the ground. I will join you in the chair. And then make a couple of neck rolls. Those of you with the chair, if you have your sticky mat nearby, ensure that your chair is on the sticky mat, as so your chair doesn't slip on you when we're going through our flow today. And then allow your eyes to close as you're rolling your neck in one direction and the other. And allow yourself to tune into natural breath. Natural breath. As you make your way back to a neutral position, chin to chest, again, this time, let your feet come apart hip distance. And then release your hands to your thighs for meditation. Eyes are soft, can be open or closed. And tune into the ebb and flow of your breath. At first, it's natural and it will begin to deepen. So very natural breathing. Relax your eyes, relax your jaw, relax your tongue. And then letting your sit bones push more into the chair, roll the shoulders back ever so slightly. For those of you leaning up against the chair, more of an openness into the heart. And now begin to expand as the belly rises. Imagine you can take your belly forward like a little hot air balloon. And then as you exhale, let your belly button draw in the direction of your spine. So you're gonna feel like a little happy pregnant lady, nice and round little belly, pressing forward. And then draw the baby back in, draw all the way in towards your spine. So deepen the connection, contraction, expansion, continue to breathe like so. Maybe even inviting the count of 3, 4, or 5 on your inhale and exhaling to 5, 6, or 7. Resistance will try to put you down. Activate your choice muscle, hope or despair.
hope lives in this moment. In this moment. Hope is a quality that exists. It carries the full power of intention when hope is at its most powerful. As we are going through difficult times in our lives, knowing that for some it's family discord, isolation during this particular time, it could be a relationship that you know needs to come to an end, or a toxic space that you're in. As the eyes are closed and the heart is open, the mind is open, and typically when the physical eyes are closed, the visual eye, the mental eye, the third eye is open. Allow it to receive these words as they fall on you. We ask the universe to fill me with clarity and courage when I'm around those who are raging and destructive. May I always remember who I am, really. A spark of your love, deserving of dignity, kindness, and self-respect. Keep me centered in even the most challenging situations. Able to say no to abuse or that which doesn't serve me. Let me love myself as you, Divine, love me. Deep breath in and out the mouth. Sweep the arms up towards the direction of the sky. Inhale. Exhale, twist to the right. Stay here, big breath in, big breath out. Inhale, reach the arms up and twist to the left. Stay here for a full round of breath. Inhale through center. Exhale, fold over the legs. Shake the head yes, shake the head no, and then roll your way up, drag yourself up, and reach the arms to the sky. Receive your blessing, hands to heart, palms touch. Breath in, breath out. Relax the hands down to the thighs, draw the chin to chest. Exhale, drop the head back, open up the throat chakra. Inhale, center. Exhale, gaze over the left. Inhale, center and right. Inhale, center. Roll the shoulders up to the ears and exhale back in. Again, exhale. Once more, exhale. Reverse your circles, roll the shoulders back and then up and forward, almost like you're drawing the pecs towards one another. And then down, big openness, and then around. Your elbows can get involved, the whole arm can get involved. So resist the urge to be very static. Start to move, start to connect. Come back to center when you are complete, and then reach the arms up. Hands rest on the knees, round the spine, scoop the pelvic floor under. So when I mean this is tuck under and round through the lower back. Create a C shape in the spine. And then inhale, slide the hands to the upper thighs, hug the elbows in and then peel your heart open and lift. Eventually the eyes look up. And then exhale, press the palms of your hands through your thighs as you drag that energy out through the knees and round your spine. And then roll the shoulders back, pull the elbows back, and lift. One more time, you got this. Roll it out. Really beautiful C shape. Stretch. And then roll back.
And then return to neutral position. Lift the right leg. Draw it in towards your chest. And make a few circles here. Now you can hold your shin, you can hold the under part of your thigh. And then reverse. So for those of you on the ground, these same pauses you can do on your back, this one here. You can also do this standing. And then release your foot down to the ground. And then the left leg lifts. I like to place my hand by my hip flexor just so I can feel that sensation of the rotation and then make a few circles here. This also helps me to stay very focused in the direction of my rotation so I'm not over rotating or under, making my circle pretty neutral, not too big, not too small. And then reverse your circle. And yes, you will hear your creaks and cracks and pops this morning. I'm already hearing mine. And when you're complete, let's come back to neutral position. Place the foot down. Sun salute. Inhale, reach the arms up. Exhale, bow forward. Feet hip distance apart. Tuck your head. Inhale, hands to shins, halfway. And exhale, drop the body back down. Rest. Inhale, arms reach up. Exhale, clear the space. Beautiful. Breath in through the nose, reach up. Bow forward. Hands to shins, inhale. And exhale, fold. Inhale, sweep up. Let's clear the space. Last round, move at your own breath pace. Inhale. Dive forward, exhale. Those in full flow, Chaturanga Dandasana. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Reach the arms up. Then hands to heart space. Big breath in. Big breath out. One more. Exhale. Reach the arms up, lean slightly forward. Maybe torso comes about 45 degrees for chair pose. In this particular angle, you want to really push your tailbone back. Push your hips back into that chair and push active into those feet. Zip up through your core, keep reaching forward. For an added challenge, hold your block or pillow and squeeze. And take three more breaths. As we come up on the next breath, inhale, exhale, bow forward. Hands to shins, exhale, bow. Rise up, right leg lifts, extend it out long in front of you. Squeeze your thigh muscle, now flex your foot. Good, like you're standing on a wall. Very good. Those of you on the mat, not using the chair, warrior one. On your exhale, release your foot down, forward fold. Halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Sweep up, left leg rises, extend, flex.
just so that way my big toe is pointing more towards the sky. And then squeeze your thigh more, lift. Utilize the lower abdominals to lift the leg. Good. And then exhale, dive forward. Make sure to breathe. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, fold. Inhale, sweep up, chair pose. Those of you full flow, bend the knees, scoop the earth, Utkatasana. Inhale to neutral spine, clear the space. Big breath in, mountain pose, fingers spread wide. I'll do this now at an angle, we do it together. Second set. Sweep up into your chair, bend forward. Now if you have a sensitive shoulder, then you want to keep your hands down or back so you're not aggravating. And then on your next breath, now let's fold all the way down. Halfway and fold. Rise up, right leg, reach up. If you do not have an arm by the side of your chair and would like to take your right foot backwards, like this, you can do that too, okay? Your choice, play around. You've got three more breaths. Squeeze your quad and smile. There it is. Not a fake smile. Okay, good. And then exhale, fold over your legs. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. That's okay, Caroline. Caroline added level two. She came into chair, and then she came back down. Reach the left leg up this time. Good. Reach, reach, reach. Nice. Good. Beautiful. Very nice, Caroline. Good. Now remember your toe position, friends. It could be slightly in more, so you're in a rotation of the quad. Lower belly, smile, breathe. Okay, let's go, down. Now we can't get this one wrong. All the way up, both legs lift. Ooh, boy, I gotta reposition myself in the chair. All right, good, squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. Good, one more and smile. Exhale, release. Let's dive it down. Reach for the backs of your ankles. Forward fold. Halfway gaze. Exhale, fold. Come to the middle of your chair if you are all over the place like me. Roll back up. Knees apart, goddess pose. Make sure your chair is on your mat specifically for this one, okay? Toes. Your knees and your toes are in the same direction. If they were in, you're gonna hurt your ankle, okay? Bend the elbows, you are a little goddess. And from here, or a little crab, or whatever you wanna be. And then we're gonna inhale, push the feet, lift up, and then exhale, lower back down. Inhale, lift, and exhale, lower. So it could be an itty bitty teeny tiny lift, or it could be a really significant one. Added challenge, lift the heels, inhale, lift, exhale, lower. And you might lower even more down so that the thighs are parallel to the ground. Okay, we got two more. Inhale, exhale, your tushy can touch the chair. Good, inhale, exhale. Egyptian head, back and forth, back and forth. Come to standing. You didn't have to really do that, y'all. Come to the back of your chair. I just like to poke fun and add more fun into my own personal practice. That's just me though, y'all. So you're gonna make sure your chair is on your mat. Make sure the sticky mat is fully underneath your chair, please. Then from here, behind your chair, measure an arm's distance. Inhale, reach the arms up. Please choose either the tallest part of your chair or the seat portion of your chair to utilize. Exhale, fold. Reach the hands to the chair head. Hips back. I need to walk my hips back. I mean my feet back, so my hips are over my heels. You want to create the letter L. Take a breath here. Bend into one knee. Come to center, bend to the other. Come to center. Now look forward. Reach the right leg up behind you. Now, you can keep your right foot on the ground if you like. Just flex your foot like we did before. Draw the right knee in towards the chest and now step the right foot forward. Lift the back heel, high lunge. Reach one arm up. Stay here if you feel comfortable. Reach two arms up. You have the chair for balance. Two more breaths. Two more breaths. One more breath. For added challenge, you can go up and down to play around. And then on the last exhale, release the hands to the chair. Turn your left foot only. We're going to come to warrior two. And for those of you remaining in the chair, extend the left leg out to the side. Like this. Mm-hmm. Now, from here, you have the option to tip back or remain here with your hand on the chair or elbow. For some, it's a little intimidating to go back. So you can go back and keep your hand on the chair or the arm. For those that are comfortable, take your peaceful warrior and take three breaths. Resist the urge to bend the back knee. This is not, this is yes. So keep the leg straight and then lift your heart to the sky. As we exhale, release your hand to the chair. Cartwheel the left hand to meet the right at the back of the chair and turn now from an open to a closed hip, high lunge. When you're comfortable, lift your arms back up. Back up. Breath in, breath out. Find plank pose, hands touch the chair. You will take your right foot to meet the left and come into a plank. Your plank can be any height or any length today, especially if you're a little bit more conscious of your practice with the chair. And then from that space, this is why it's very important, it's got to be on a sticky mat, bend the elbows and bring your heart towards the chair. This will require you to squeeze the core and your butt super much and squeeze the legs together tight, 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 tight. Once you're here, you're going to pull yourself up to the sky and then let your hips come forward, but squeeze your butt a lot. Lift your heart. Then exhale, slide your tushy back and find leg. It's a very strong pose. Very, very need to have that chair on the sticky mat, okay? Or it slips like mine just did. And then from here, left leg lifts. Inhale, reach it back. Hold your chair. No need to do anything else fancy here. Bend your knee and draw it in so that you can step it forward as far between the little legs of the chair as possible. Lift your back heel. Melt a little bit here. You can stay right here. You can hang out right here like Caroline. She likes to chill. You could do that. You can raise the arms if you like. One or the other. And hang out there. One more breath. As we exhale, release the hands to touch the chair. And then kindly just turn the right foot out. So it's parallel to the edge of your mat over there. Arms to a T if that's for you, or you can rest and look over the left shoulder. If you're sitting, I'll stay with you here. Warrior two. Pitch back, peaceful. Those in the chair, right hand down, left arm lifts, let it ride down the side of your leg. It's beautiful. Couple of breaths. One more. Now take your time as we cartwheel the hands. Those of us in the chair, we're going to come back to center. And then warrior one. Reach the arms up. Reach the arms up, those in the chair. Slide your leg in and extend the leg out. Beautiful. Big breath in. And big breath out. One more. Exhale. Step your right foot to meet the left. And fold, finding downward dog. Walk your dog, paddle your feet. This is a lot of creaky, cracky, peepy poppies. It's okay. So we're gonna go through one more flow before we add some balance. I'm gonna turn my chair to the median height. This might be a little bit easier for some, more challenging for others. It's up to you to decide where you like to go. Place it at the top of your mat. Inhale, the arms reach up. Exhale, dive forward. Optional forward fold. Gaze is lifted halfway. Your hands are touching the chair. Exhale, fold. Walk your feet back slightly. Find downward dog. Bend into one knee and then the other. And please invite your breath to return. If you have an arm on your chair, this is really, really a sweet option to use that. And then from here, inhale, reach the right leg up. Exhale, step the right foot forward. Warrior one, option to stay in lunge, your choice. Deep breath in, deep breath out. Return to a warrior two this time. Open, my badness. So it's just your back foot that turns, my beautiful friends. Peaceful warrior takes it up and over, reaching up through the ribs. Expand your light, shine. Take your right hand down to the chair, either to the top or to the bottom or to your thigh. Reach the left arm up. Modify triangle. If you like a full triangle, straighten the front leg. Couple of breaths. Your eye gaze can be down for your neck if it's a little sensitive, or up in the direction of your hand. Exhale, release, bend the knee, float the left hand down, right arm slowly back up. And cartwheel your hand to the chair. Turn now from open to closed hips, so be very mindful here. And then planting your hands into that chair, step your right leg back to meet your left plank pose. Very good. Again, now you have the option to stay here, hinge back, downward dog. Or bend the elbows and come down. Inhale, sweep forward into your up dog or cobra. And exhale, downward loving dog. And smile. And breathe. And smile again. And breathe again. Good. Inhale, left leg rises up to the heavens above, nice and strong. Kick, kick, kick. And then take the left foot forward. Back foot either turns or is lifted, it's your choice, and let's come up. Up, 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 up. Good. Melt into this space. Feel free to close your eyes if you wish. Close your eyes. You know your sequence, you know your flow. Trust. Open up, warrior two. Feel that energy all the way through one fingertip to the other fingertip. Nice and strong. Good, play tug of war with your body. Let your back arm win, so you're nice and long. Good. And then go ahead and pitch back. Pitch back. Good. Breathe in. Through the nose, exhale. Sweep the left hand down,
either to your chair, to your thigh, to the top of your chair, right arm up, or coming into a little triangle. You can keep the knees slightly bent or start to straighten the leg. Get into that hamstring. Good. Breathing. Is smiling. Inviting that hope. What muscle are we working? Our hope or despair? And don't you answer despair right now in yoga. Don't you do it. No, hoping is always good. Bend the knee, float back, right hand down, left arm lifts. Reach up. Stretch. Exhale, cartwheel the hands down to the chair. Find that left foot meeting the right. Exhale, begin to lower. And then when you're ready, sweep up into little cobra. And exhale, down dog. Walk your dog. And then walk your feet in ever so slightly. Not too much. Just so the heels come back beneath the hips. And now you have the option to utilize the base of this chair, or if you like to come a little higher, use the taller portion of your chair or the arm of your chair. Coming into warrior three. Right leg lifts. Again, you can keep the toe on the ground. Left arm lifts. If you feel comfortable, right arm lifts. If you're using the back of the chair, this is a nice one. Because my seniors like this one a lot. Rest your hands on the chair. Warrior three. This is their warrior three. So there's always, when there's a will, there's a way. And laugh. And smile. And fall. And then let it go. No attachment. It's over. Right foot down. Shake it out. Team girl squad. And they say, it's over. My favorite part. I just dated myself, y'all. Okay. Left leg rises. Extend. Right arm lifts. Or rest. Laugh. Smile. Big thing. Your toe needs to point down to the ground. It should not turn out. It should stay down. So you keep your hips in the same plane. Okay? And work. Good. Working is good. Just because it's chair yoga doesn't mean that we're not working. Right? One more breath. One for good luck. Now draw your foot down. It's over. And shake it out. Now I like to do half moon, but on the bottom of the chair for this balance. So I show you. Some of you might already know. Please go there. Otherwise, solidify that left leg. Left hand strong in this, on the middle of your chair. Right leg lifts. Option one, stay here. Good option. Option two, right hand, right hip. Start to turn. Squeeze your butt. Now kick your leg. It's like a ninja kick. And then stay there. You have your hand on the chair and push. You can take your other hand anywhere you like. I like it on my hip. Good. And then smile. Yes, you're gonna shake. Yes, you're gonna wiggle. And yes, you're gonna fall. And yes, you're gonna laugh it all off and do it again. Because it's a practice. Good. Yeah, as y'all know, I don't take myself seriously. And then on your next breath, begin to lower that down, turn, and shake it out. Shake it out, fall out, laugh it off. Sober. Now we have another side. So I'm just going to change my chair so that I can see y'all. Shake it out. Let it go. Get out of your head. Right hand down. I'm sorry, left hand down. The other side, y'all. Lift the leg. push very active into that right hand, left hand, left hip, and start to turn. And squeeze your butt. And squeeze your butt. And flex your foot. That's what you got this chair for. Some of you on the upper portion of the chair, totally relaxing. Oh boy. And breathe, Caroline. It's my roommate. My goddess. It's my goddess. And one more breath, friends. Laugh, laugh, laugh. So, huh. So good. Let's come back to center. It's over. Shake it out and have a little fun with all that. We're coming down now. We're all going to come down to the ground now, so it's going to be good. But wait, we got one more. One more, friends. One more. We cannot stop without tree pose. Roll up. Release. This is a nice utilization of your chair. If you want to keep your hip near the right hip, close to the left side of your chair. So that way, if you timber over, you have your support. Otherwise, you can utilize the back portion of the chair and play with that. When you're ready, inhale, lift the left foot, turn it out to the side, and place it anywhere on your leg. Grow your trees when you're ready. Any variation of trees welcome here. If you happen to have the chair and you want to put your toes on the chair, working on half lotus, then go right ahead and utilize that to begin your stretch. Three more breaths. Add a challenge, close your eyes. Bring your hands together, palms touch. Release the left foot down. Shake that out. Marilyn. I always like to Marilyn in this particular class because this reminds me of my students, one in particular that we just lost to the virus over at Lambeth House. So this is his pose. So we continue to do his pose. So we're gonna come to center, other side. Left side of the body. Presses up against the left side of the chair. If you don't need to press, then just use it as a base. Right foot lifts, take it out to the side. Thank you. And draw your hands together to heart. If you'd like, you can place your foot on the chair and breathe. Five breaths. On your fifth breath, bring your hands together to heart space. And release your foot down. Shake that out, let it go. And then turn, if you're looking at me or your chair is in a different direction, let's turn and face the chair. And let's just move the chair again to the top edge of our mat. Move my thing out of the way. Just to the top edge of your mat so you have a support to come down. And then arms distance away from the chair, we're going to reach the arms back up. And then bow forward, exhale. Touch the chair, release the head. Shake yes, shake no. Inhale, roll forward, shoulders over your wrists. And baby plank. Baby plank, because you're not going to be here long. You're just going to come down to your knees, like in prayer. And then sit back, move your legs out of the way, and come to the mat. And now if you're able to just scoot your chair out of the way for a minute, you can. Just push it very top of your mat. Top, because you probably use it for Shavasana. We're gonna start to make our way down as we roll down. And arms out in front of us. Scoop under. And then press your feet nice and strong into the mat. Imagine you can pull your heels so far into your tushy, but you can't move your feet though. But just imagine that you can. And then roll down. And make sure there's nothing that's gonna bump your head. Like your hair clip. Like your hair clips. Or anything else. And then draw your knees into your chest, please, and hug yourself here. Rocking from side to side. And then bringing your knees out to the side in the opposite direction, feet together, a little butterfly. And if you like to rock your butterfly. If your head is hanging back here and your chin is in the sky, then please bring your chin towards your chest. Maybe take a pillow and place it underneath your head to bring the earth to you so that the spine is long as opposed to being overstretched or impinged. Impinged is the word I'm looking for. And then bring the knees together, legs to 90 degrees. Option to take any leg variations here if you like to lift and lower or touch the chair and bring the legs back up. You'll be working through your lower abdominals at that point. Protect your lower back if you are working through there. And if you like, you can always just lift the hips and lower and lift and lower and play with that as well for 5 rounds of breath. If you'd like to come into plow pose without turning your head from side to side, go ahead and take your legs overhead, touch the earth behind you. And for those of you that would like to take bridge pose, feet down, heels beneath the knees, lift the hips. Draw the chin in, so you're opening up the back of the neck, and walk the hands down towards your heels. Those of you coming into shoulder stand, support your lower back and let the legs come back up to 90. And when you hit that 5th rotation of breath, come down. Those of you in inversions, take your time to return back to the earth. Windshield wiper the knees from side to side. Side to side. And then return back to center, right knee in, hug. The right foot over the left knee. Flex, push away that right hip flexor, right knee. Those of you that would like a lot more, then lift that left leg, maybe even all the way up to the sky. You can use your chair here and push your chair and help you, kind of like a leg rest. And then when you're ready, take that right leg all the way over the left. Left foot touches the earth and swing the hips over to the right. Only if this is comfortable for you, go ahead and take that knee, both knees bound, over to the left. At this here, right at the lower right back, for some of us, me with sciatica, those of you that are suffering with any lower back sensitivity, take a block or a pillow and place it under the knee and rest. Don't go too far.
Just go just to your edge. You don't need to go any further than that. If you're feeling the sensation, there's no need to aggravate it. And then yes, gaze to the right. Gaze to the right and smile. Smile. Back to center on an inhale. Lift the hips, return them back to neutral, and let's switch these lovely legs. Left knee in, right foot down. Get a little stretch, and then take the left foot over the right and push the knee away. And if you chose to go a little deeper, a little further in the other options, please do so on this side. Slide the left leg over the right, cross. Right foot comes down so you can swing the hips over to the left and start to turn to the right. So this side's very open for me. And then open to the left. And again, same options apply. If it's not so open, let's bring the earth to you. Put that pillow there. Put that block there. Maybe even your water bottle. And then look over to the left. Your right hand can rest on your thigh to help support you. Or it can be out into a T. Lovingly draw yourself back to center, to neutral position. Push down to rise and then release your hips back down. Draw your knees back in, make your circles opposing directions. And reverse the circle. Taking one more pose before Shavasana, whatever that is for you. Happy baby. Recline bound angle, feet together, knees apart on the ground. Those with your chair, bring your chair back. Take your legs up and over the chair and maneuver yourself down. You might take a pillow or a blanket and place that under your head. And if you have anything to put over your hips, like weight, any type of a nice little weight or a book or a block, blanket is nice. And now you make yourself your bed. And you can watch TV like this too. And just relax, friends, relax. This is also a modified legs up the wall pose. For those of you that the legs go numb, being in an inversion for too long, that happens to me, I use a chair. I'll come to seated meditation while y'all are making your way into Shavasana. As you make your way there, please allow the whole body to rest. All of the energy flows out through the toes, the fingers. Rest the back of your neck and your head. Allow the lower back to relax. The eyes begin to get heavy. The eyes may even close. And as the physical eyes close, the third eye opens into full awareness through meditation. As we give ourselves a pep talk today, and that's your good deed, is to give yourself a pep talk. Activate your choice muscle, hope or despair, resistance will try to put you down, and hope lives in this moment. The power of hope is here every day. It is a quality that exists like joy. Hope carries the full power of intuition when hope is at its most powerful. If you are going through these difficult times, as we all are, fear of this unknown, the isolation, the discord, the exhaustion, whether it's a bad or toxic relationship or friendship, give yourself a pep talk and be hopeful. Fill me with clarity and courage, Divine Source, when I'm around those who are raging and destructive. May I always remember who I am, really. A spark of your love, deserving of respect, kindness, dignity, and self-respect. Keep me centered in even the most challenging situations, able to say no to abuse and that which doesn't serve me. Let me love myself as you, Divine Source, love me.
Oh, you're not.
begin to breathe awareness back into your fingers and your toes. And inviting yourself to come into a good morning stretch. And drawing yourself into a little ball and hugging yourself here. And gently rolling back and forth and all the little motions. Now it might take a little bit longer to come out of Shavasana, so take your time. The eyes are closed, you're in a meditative state. And once you're there, then roll yourself to a seated position. Either on your chair or in the center of your mat. Bringing your hands together and the palms touch. Bowing to yourself to honor your practice, to honor your dignity, your self-worth, your self-respect. To bask in the essence of hope as we exercise our choice muscle. To focus on things that serve our higher good. In times of despair, we come together as a collective for healing, continuing to share in the same mindset. The light that lives in me honors and delights in the light that lives in each of you. May you have a blessed rest of your week. And I'll see you tomorrow. Together we close our class with the sound of Om. Om. Om Shanti 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 Om Namah Shivaya. Om Jai Bhagwan Ki Jai. Namaste.
Namaste.
Namaste.